Our gospel reading this morning comes from the Gospel of Luke, the first chapter. Listen for God's word to us. In those days, Mary set out on another case to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord." And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham, and who is to his descendants forever." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all of our hearts be acceptable in the sight of the Lord, our God, and our Redeemer. Amen. So here we are on the fourth Sunday of Advent. And we know that's true because we have four candles that actually got lighted. That was good. But it is the morning of Christmas Eve, is it not? Now it's tempting to slide right into Christmas with the baby, the manger, and the shepherds. We may already be thinking about the gifts under the tree and a big meal with the family. We are waiting to see, or already have seen, Miracle on 34th Street, or It's a Wonderful Life, or maybe Christmas Vacation. We are ready to sing the Christmas carols and light up for the candle lighting services. But hold on. It's still Advent. The waiting is still happening. We can't, nor shall we, overlook today's message for the fourth Sunday of Advent. Our reading from Luke is the beautiful song of hope expressed by Mary, the mother of Jesus. You may know it as the Magnificat. But before we get to Mary's song, which we just heard, let's back up a moment and think about this teenager. The year is about 4 BC, well over 2,000 years ago. Mary is around 13. As with most girls back then, she is probably slender, olive-skinned, and long, straight brunette hair. She is, in all probability, happy, energetic, and well-schooled in the Jewish faith. She loves her God with her whole heart. Mary believes in the one true God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. In the evenings, she loves to sit around the fire and listen to stories about Moses and his sister Miriam, David and Michael, and of Abigail. The stories about the struggles of the prophets amaze and excite her every time she hears them. Like other girls her age, Mary gets up early, fetches water from the town well, and helps with the washing of clothes. Gathering with the other women is where Mary and the others find out about the happenings in the village and the surrounding areas. Growing up in the obscure village of Nazareth, Mary lives in a war-torn and conquered land. The people are unfairly taxed, bullied, and despised by the rulers. Some of the people rebel against the Roman soldiers who are garrisoned in the area, but most just stay away from them. Mary's parents had made plans for her to marry, as was customary in those days. They chose Joseph, a carpenter, for her husband. Now, Joseph is older than Mary, but she agrees with their decision. Though legally binding, the marriage will not be consummated until after the wait period of 1 year. During this time, Mary will live at home with her parents. She will not physically be Joseph's wife until that year is up. Mary knows that someday the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob will send a Messiah to free the people of Israel, the chosen people of God. She believes this in her deepest part of her heart. She and others have seen signs that point to the Messiah's coming soon. Then something astounding happens. Mary is greeted by a visitor, the angel Gabriel. He tells her that she will become pregnant, but should not be afraid. She has been chosen, favored by God, to play an important role in the history of the world. Remember, Mary is a teenager, probably about the age of 13. How can she explain a seemingly arrogant story of being made pregnant by the Holy Spirit of God? A pregnant woman of Mary's status is declared damaged goods, open to rejection by any future husband, abandoned by her family, and the target of possible stoning. Yet, when Mary is certain of the pregnancy, she takes a very long trip to the hill country of Judea to visit her cousin Elizabeth. Though we do not know the details of their conversation for the 3 months that they were together, we do know that Elizabeth realizes that something important has happened to Mary. Elizabeth sang out, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb." And Mary replies to Elizabeth with a song that sings about her love of the Lord, a reflection of the song Hannah sang 1,000 years earlier. Mary's song points to her belief and her hope in a God who can do marvelous things. She is not somehow protected from the harsh reality of life. It is in spite of her situation that Mary continues to believe and hope in a God who can do marvelous things. You see, God chose Mary because in the midst of the reality of her circumstances, she continues to be open to the call of God. Listen to the words of Mary's song, this time from Eugene Peterson's The Message, and you will discover the Holy Spirit speaking of how God's divine plan will impact the world. Mary said, "I'm bursting with God news. I'm dancing the song of my Savior God. God took one look at me and look what happened. I'm the most fortunate woman on the earth. What God has done for me will never be forgotten. The God whose very name is holy, set apart from all others. His mercy flows in wave after wave on those who are in awe before him. He bared his arm and showed his strength, scattering the bluffing braggarts. He knocked tyrants off their high horses, pulled victims out of the mud. The starving poor sat down to a banquet. The callous rich were left out in the cold. He embraces his chosen child, Israel. He remembered and piled on the miracles, piled them high. It's exactly what he promised, beginning with Abraham and right up to now. Mary is a marvelous girl. And there are many times that we forget. We forget what she went through. We forget that she actually gave her life to bring our Savior into the world. Mary carried that child, birthed that child, raised that child, and then watched that child die. But Mary also saw her risen Lord. It is my prayer that in this season of Advent and Christmas, our hearts will be drawn to give our joyful obedience to the Lord. The good news is news to live as well as news to celebrate. There are so many in our world who are not included in the blessings. In the blessings that we enjoy. In the blessings that we take for granted. What a wonderful Christmas gift it would be for Jesus Christ if his people would rise up and join him in lifting up the lowly and filling the hungry with good things. Friends, when we choose to do what Christ asks, we discover that perfect obedience leads to perfect happiness. When we choose to do what Christ asks, the many who have been left out will come to know the God who bestows blessings. When we choose to do what Christ asks, we will be able to join Mary in her song. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. Friends, let us sing as Mary sings and proclaim the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Let us pray. Gracious God, we thank you for this reminder of who Mary was and what she did for you and for us. She gave her life willingly to bring forth your Savior, our Savior, the Savior of the world. And so, Lord, we thank you for this reminder. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.